The White House says Russia is to blame for recent cyber attacks on Ukraine's defense industry and major banks. And now the U.S. and every American is a target.
If Russia attacks the United States or our allies through asymmetric activities, like disruptive cyber attacks against our companies or critical infrastructure, we are prepared to respond.
In 2020, Russian hackers got into SolarWinds. Last year, meat supplier JBS and Colonial Pipeline both fell victim to a ransomware attack. U.S. officials signaling this current threat is definitely state-sponsored, and there is a greater sense of urgency.
I think absolutely that the U.S. should be very concerned. I think Russia at the same time is going to use tactics. They're going to be targeting our critical infrastructure in the United States.
Expert Scott Schober, who has written several books on cybersecurity, says that critical infrastructure includes oil refineries, power grids, healthcare facilities, even transit. They are all targets. In April 2021, the MTA says they were breached by hackers with suspected ties to the Chinese government. It was immediately caught, and the cyber criminal didn't get very far. A security patch was installed.
I always tell people, realize it's impossible. The cyber criminals have to get it right just one time. The good guys have to get it right every time, and there's no way they could possibly shore up every vulnerability.
The White House says it's increasing cyber defenses here at home, but the reality is much of our infrastructure is older and not updated regularly, leaving us vulnerable to attacks. While much of that is out of our control, Schober says there are things we can do individually. Always use strong and long passwords that are difficult to hack. Use unique passwords, meaning a different one for each account. Multi-factor authentication for extra security. And a reminder, don't click on email attachments or pop